So we're gonna change the plugs on the Tundra, and it's got a 5.7 V8, and we got a squeeze clamp. We squeeze this here, and we can slide this connector up. And they have coil packs on them, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna crack all of the 10 millimeters loose here, and then I can get like an extension in here, and I'll take them all off. Let me make sure they all crack loose. Don't want to break nothing. Okay, we're going to take the plugs off. Okay. Okay. And we always, when we take the coil packs out, we silicone spray them, that's the way we like to do them. And then I let them dry, and then I change the plugs while I'm letting the coil packs dry. We put a little dielectric grease under them. This engine has a nice little catch tray here for everything for us. To hit these with the zip gun, or I like to take them out and then by hand. And we're gonna put some never sees on these. Okay, so we can grab onto the coil pack, give it a little twist, and pull it up. Okay, so this is what we're going to do. We're going to put dielectric grease in the boot, and we're going to spray this all with silicone, and we're going to set them up here and let them dry. And that's what we're going to do to all of them. So let's get this all set up in here. I like to put them back in the same spot. It really doesn't make a difference, but I just personally like to do it like that. Some of these are a little tight, and sometimes you gotta move, you know, a few things. We have this electrical bracket that's here in the way, and you know, we may have to move some of the stuff. This coil is hitting it. We're gonna try and bend this out of the way a little bit if we can. Get this to just slide up, work it out. Okay, we get that one out. Same thing with this one. Give them a little spin, break them loose. Okay, so we get these four out. So we're gonna show you how we do the silicone spray and the dielectric grease. And then we're gonna get something to pull the plug out. Let's get these set up going. I have the dielectric grease. And I'm just gonna squeeze a little bit into the boot. That's all I gotta put in there. Do all of these. You know, these coils are crazy in price. Some of them are, you know, you can buy inexpensive ones for 16, and you can buy OEM ones for, you know, 75 to 90 bucks a piece. And you got eight of them on this engine. It can add up pretty quick. So what we're doing here is we're gonna stand them up. I stand them up over a barrel normally over here. And I'm just gonna spray these all with silicone. And what this does is when this dries, it protects this boot and keeps it moist so that it's not going to leak and let spark short out on the cylinder head. So I do all of these, give them all a quick spray, and then I just let them dry while I'm changing the spark plugs. So we'll do all of these, we're gonna let these dry, and then we're gonna go in and show you how we do spark plugs. We got a 5/8 socket, with an extension, and we're going to slide this down, and it fits right in there. I'm going to get the extension. We'll stop pulling this one out, and we get, grab a ratchet, and we'll do all four of these, and we get our new plugs. We'll check the gap on them, and then we'll put a little never seize on the threads of the plugs, slide them down in place. And you kind of want to do this when the engine's cool. You don't want to do this with a red hot engine. If your extension's a little long, you got to try and find the one that works for you. Once I get it cracked loose, I'm going to pop my ratchet off. Back this out by hand. Don't want to impact these guys. You know, there's a few things that you need to do with patience. Changing your spark plugs is one of them. Okay, so let's go over to the light and see how these burned. We got our roll plug, and it burned nice, you know. So we're going to do one at a time, and it's going to be the same procedure, guys, to do this. We may not show you all of them. So the old plug gap, we checked that it was at 44. Now, you can't really gap these because you'll snap the tip, the iridium tip off. So this had some wear on it, and these were at about 44. And then we're just checking the new one just to make sure the box wasn't dropped and the thing's not pushed down your electrode. And this new one is at like 40. So we're going to put a little never seize on the threads, and then we're going to slide this back down into the hole, and we're going to do this same procedure. You just need a little bit on here, and it's going to work its way in, and we'll slide it into our socket here. And we're going to go slide this in. Now, we have this long tube in here. These are recessed so far down in the head that I don't think this is going to reach. So, you know, more than likely, we wouldn't be able to use this. Most of the cars, we can use it. But on the ones with the cylinders, with the plugs recessed down into the valve cover, it's kind of like a Hemi engine, you have to use an extension. So we're going to go with this route and use the extension. I'm just going to slide this down nice and slow. You'll see how you'll feel it fall in place. And then we're going to thread it all down by hand as far as we can. And then we're going to put the ratchet on there. We'll snug it down. You don't want to kill it. You're just going to snug it down. There's a lot of threads on these. Snug. Let's get our socket off. We're going to take our coil pack that we've already got our silicone spray and our dielectric grease in there, and we can slide this down in place. Move our plug here. And we have our bolt here. We're going to put some never seize on this. You know, these are going into aluminum valve cover. And, you know, you want to make sure that these things are lubed with never seize, because you don't want this thing to break on you. And like I said, I don't snug these down with an impact gun. You know, I just like to tighten this stuff up by hand. Just snug that up. That's it there. We inspected our connector here. Yep. Just to make sure we don't have any corrosion. The pin's nice and clean and tight. I don't really feel the need to put dielectric grease in there right now. So what we're going to do is we're going to put that on. We heard a click. And when we're done, we're going to take this silicone spray and we're gonna just go over all of our plug wires like this. So we're gonna just give the coil a little spray along with the cap, and after we get done them all, we're gonna do the same procedure to all of them. So we were able to use our Thexton extension to get on the spark plugs, and we just put a little Nevisees on them, and this does reach down into there, and it is kind of convenient. So slide this down there. We checked our plug gap just to make sure, and this will slide down right there, and we'll catch our threads. It's just long enough. Run them all down as far as you can with the tool.
I'll put that a link in the description of the video for that tool for you guys, because you tend to ask about it quite a bit. So if you want to check it out, it's on.
This just came off, and this just sits on the cylinder head here. A little rubber here underneath the boot. I guess I can slide this. The other one stayed right on. This can just lock onto, just locked into the boot. See, it's got the little clip right there. The other one stayed, all of them stayed on. None of them, actually those came off, just this first two didn't. So this will stay on with the boot. And these are all silicone sprayed and dielectric greased. So all I have to do is tighten this thing up now. Ratchet, and it's very tight. There it goes. Okay, we'll get our coil on this one. It's already sprayed and dried. Let's slide this down. We put the little booty back on it. This one was a little tight coming down, but we're gonna get it down there. Rotate it into place. And we're gonna take our bolt, put a little Nevisees on it. This one with the 10 millimeter. We're just snugging it up. We're gonna put our clip back on, listen for the click. And we're gonna put a little spray on this, just like we're gonna do all the rest of them. Okay. And we're gonna do the same procedure on the rest of the plugs on this side. And we'll go over the passenger side witcher, and it looks pretty clear and open, and we'll go over that side briefly, but it's the same procedure. Like I said, we laid all of our boots out, sprayed them with silicone, put the dielectric grease in there. You can lay all your spark plugs out and check the gap on them. I like to check the gap on them. You never know if the box was dropped, before you go in there. So you give them a good inspection. And, when you're pulling the old plug out, you're looking at the old plug to make sure that it burned properly and it's not black. That would be an indication of something going on with the engine. So, so far, everything looks good. We're going to move on to the next plug, and then we'll let you know how we make out. So I'm on the third coil pack, third spark plug back here on the passenger side. I just want to go over a couple of things. For this second one over here, I ended up using a swivel socket because I have my extension here, and it was a little tight, the 6-inch extension with the swivel. And now I have the cooling tube in the way, so I just put a little 3-inch extension on my 6-inch with the swivel, and I'm taking this one out. And the back one here, this last coil we took off, I just had to lift up on this bracket a little bit here, and I was able to get the coil out. So it's a little tighter on this side, but there was really nothing that really restricted me. I used a deep 10 millimeter with the 3/8 and with the quarter drive ratchet to get the bolts off of the coil packs. We did the same procedure. We already sprayed them with silicone, and we put the dielectric grease in the middle. Just this side is just a little bit tighter, and I found that the swivel socket on the end of my extension is what I ended up using to take these out. But it's the same procedure. It's just a little tighter on this side. We just wanted to let you know, guys know. So this one, I'm going to pull this one out. I'll show you the setup that I used. They've all been coming out fairly good. They get to a certain point where they just, you know, loosen right up, and you can put the Thexton boot thing on and, you know, finish taking them out the rest of the way. But this one's got this coolant tube kind of right in my face, so. They should be good here. So this is the setup that I got. Just backing it out a little bit here. Seems pretty loose now, but I just got the swivel with this setup here. Everything's got a little wobble to it, and it really made a difference on getting this one and the second one out. And I'll use my boot right now, finish getting the rest of the spark plug out. You can use a piece of 3/8 rubber hose too. And we get this one. After this one's done, we got one left. But we're doing the same procedure. We're checking our spark plug gap. You know, the new ones are at 40. Making sure that got dropped. That's right at 40. Putting a little bit of Nevisease on the threads here. It'll work its way in. You don't have to kick it on. I'll slide this down and snug it up. And then I'll just use my swivel socket and extension setup to tighten it down. And the last one, it's going to be the same thing. I'm going to use the swivel adapter on that one. And after we get these all back in and the coils plugged in, one other thing I want to talk about, this second one in here was a little tight because of the harnesses right here. So we had a hard time lifting up the boot. So if you take the bolt off and you just swing the coil pack over this way, it'll come off a lot easier. That was the only one that really gave us a hard time because the plug's coming up and it's hitting the rest of the harness here. But that was it. So, but it's going, it's not too bad to do.
Okay, so we got all our plugs in it. And, you know, the passenger side was a little more difficult than the driver's side. He showed you, if, you know, you're gonna need a swivel socket, a little extension and stuff. A little Thexton tool really worked good, but it really wasn't that much more difficult to do the passenger side. Obviously easier on the driver's side. It's running nice and smooth, and that'll be it.